All right, here we go. Big Daddy Shin, day 287 at 24 Hour Fitness. So today I'm about to get hit up by that car. That'd be live, right? But yeah, had a pretty busy day. After school, I went to go to meet Norma to go and get some World Series gear, Dodger Stadium, instead of working out. And so when I went there, yes, access denied. Everything was like sold out. And then I talked to my buddy Jude, and he said like, "Oh yeah, you know, it was they said on the news it was all sold out." I'm like, "Shoot, what are we gonna do, right?" Anyways, let me check in. Okay, so yeah, told DeAndre my story about World Series. So yeah, go over there. So I don't have gear, but I have tickets. So yeah, I'm waiting for the tickets to be released on my account. Kind of a weird thing. You buy the tickets, right? And then they don't let you have access to them until the day before the event. I mean, it shows you have it in your account, but the day before, then you could do something with it. Because I guess they don't want people to start, like, selling it. Even though they're going for, like, $800. I mean, would I sell it for $800? You bet I would, right? But, yeah, so they're trying to prevent against that to make, like, the prices lower or whatever. But that's another video. But then so, yeah, so I was over there, and then I realized that they don't even have the World Series patch. That was sold out, too. I was like, shoot, well, let me get on this bike. All right, here we go. Come on, 273. Yeah, I lost 2 pounds. It's really weird. I'll explain in a second. And 3, 2, 1. Okay, so all I had today was 2 In-N-Out burgers. So that's about like 1,300 calories, right? And then so, yeah, went to, you know, drove back, and then I didn't have time. I had to go to the bathroom, take a shower. And then, what I did was, they're still out of the World Series patches. So if you see my regular Big Daddy shirt, I have the 2017 World Series patch. And then so what happens is they have a new one this year, 2018. It's pretty cool. I'm like, oh man, so what do? I take off the one on my sleeve and then put that one on? So that was option A, right? So I'm thinking, okay, how do I get this iron on off? So I go on YouTube and I see all these videos of people using acetone. I guess like nail polish remover, but the heavy duty one. You put it on your shirt, especially if it's white. Thank goodness my shirt's white. And then it takes away the sticky stuff, makes the sticky stuff like peel off. I'm like, oh, okay. So then I was watching some of them do it. I'm like, oh, okay, I think this works. And then so I was thinking about it. I'm like, wait a minute. I have that original Big Daddy Shin jersey that I bought. And then the dude from downtown Korea, or LA town, or garment district, the Korean dude, he messed up my shirt. You know, I went to that guy because he's Korean. You know, I'm Korean too, so not my people, right? And the guy said, oh yeah, I did a lot of these shirts. I did hundreds. I at the time, I thought hundreds was a lot, but no. So then I told him, yeah, you know, well, okay, put the lettering on, like just place it, take a picture, and then put it on when I prove it. Okay, right? And then so he did it. I took the picture. The lettering was off. I mean, yeah, A, it was crooked. And B, these look like Little League letters. And then, and also the 5, the different number 5, whatever. And so I'm not going to walk around the park with like this authentic jersey with like numbers that are bootleg, right? They would like give me crap. And then also, it's not like I have like someone's real name on, like a player. No, it had my name on it. So they go, oh, look at this bootleg shirt that he has. Big Daddy Shin, fake, right? So I told him, nah, I'm going to go somewhere else. He says, too late. I glued and stitched him on already. I'm like, what? So, yes, I mean, thank goodness I got a discount on it, but still, that's a couple hundred dollars down the drain, right? So all of a sudden, you know, I got another one. I got the one that you guys see me wear. But then today, I was thinking, wow, if that acetone thing works, maybe I could take off the stitching of that shirt and then acetone the glue and then put real stuff on, and then I could put the World Series patch. Okay, so as a result, I took my jersey, or I got one of those little stitch remover things. My fingers hurt so bad right here because I was just doing it and then pulling off the... Oh, that hurts when I just do that. And then so instead of dance class, that's what I did, because it takes a long time. And then when you start something and you don't finish it, you get frustrated. So there's no way I'd be able to dance, thinking like, oh, I gotta take these numbers off. And so I don't even know if the acetone thing's gonna work, but I do want to get the numbers off by tomorrow, so after school I can get the acetone, put it on it while I'm watching the game, afterwards wash the jersey and see if the things come off, and then if it works, then on Wednesday I'm going back to Lids and get my lettering on it, right? So we'll see what happens. I mean, what can we do? So I don't know. Yeah, and ticket prices. Yeah, they're pretty expensive. They're about triple right now. But still, even if it's double, that's a lot. Because where I normally sit, okay, during the year, my seats are $40. I mean, depends on where. If a couple rows back, then $36. So that's per game. In the playoffs, the first round goes with $66. Okay, not too bad. And then next round is $92, right? And for World Series, $350. So I'm like, oh my gosh, that's pretty crazy. So I didn't buy the playoff tickets. And then, so, you know, I had an opportunity to do the World Series one. So I figure, okay, I saved the money from playoffs to get the World Series one. But still, it's like, you know, like I was telling DeAndre, it's like, man, $800. That means you buy the ticket for $350 and someone on StubHub buys it for $8. You're like, okay, that's $450. Well, minus service fees, probably about $50. And then, it's $400 to watch the game at home. Not worry about $30 parking. So that's a pretty good option. But World Series energy is ridiculous. It's pretty amazing. So we'll see what happens. I mean, right now it's just all talk until something happens, right? So yes, the reason why I told that story, I'm just gonna do the bike and I'm gonna go home. It's 11, I'm not sure. But then I need to sleep. I need to sleep, I got a lot of stuff I gotta do. And my body feels great though. Oh my gosh, when I'm like driving, I feel my muscle in the car. Right now, when I went like this, yeah, I squeeze my chest, I feel like the Incredible Hulk. And then like, and the biceps I gotta do more because I'm not feeling that as much, but my chest is pumped. My shoulders, yes. So the time's coming, day's coming, gotta be patient. You guys are gonna watch me transform. See, there we go. Solid, rock, there we go. All right, there we go, sub 50. I didn't do abs in a long time, so let's do some abs, right? That's something. Oh, wow. Stunning.
All right, here you go. Day 287 in the books. All right, DeAndre. See you later. Awesome. All right, so I'll see you tomorrow.
Yep.
All right, awesome. All right, so yeah, do the whole cardio, quick cardio coming out. Saw the ab machine, and then so I did it right or something because it's like I really feel a burn on it. And then so after that first, I didn't even know how many I did the first time. I just kept counting to 10. And that seemed like it worked pretty well. And then so, did a couple more sets after I turned it off. And now I'm just like all abbed out. But, you know, I feel good. I mean, it's weird because I didn't really eat that much. But, you know, today's like my day off of eating or something. Just had just the two double-doubles. But, you know, have my calories. But tomorrow we'll see too, because Tuesday, Dodger game. Usually get something to eat before that, watch it at home. And then we'll see. Anyways, time to get home. I need to go home, rest. And we'll see what happens, right? But anyways, nothing profound. Day 287, just getting it in. And recovering my upper body. I was going to do some curls, no. And then... just getting my workout in. That's what today is, recovering and just enjoying the new feel of my body. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Enjoying life. But anyways, Big Daddy Shit, day 287. If I could exercise 287 days in a row, you could exercise 287 days in a row. If I could do it, you could do it. Wow, I'm approaching 300. Wow, that's pretty crazy, huh? But, wow, that's pretty nuts. But anyways, I'm doing it in more anyways, right? So let me just get home and sleep, but I'll see you tomorrow. Yes. Okay, awesome.